We're flying over Pine Island Sound, headed to Pine Island. And Sebastian, I'm almost afraid of what we're going to see here. Because Pine Island took a really hard hit. And then we'll try to get to Matlacha, but I've been watching the footage come in for days through a screen, and now to see it firsthand is a whole different kind of emotion that goes through you. I know you've been on the ground here, and you had a moment, didn't you? So so this is heading into Flamingo Bay, they call it. And some of the homes, it's just wiped out. A lot of these were manufactured homes. A lot of boats up on the water. This is a fishing community, you know, hardworking fishermen and retirees who came here to kind of live out the rest of their days in a small, tight-knit community where the water's everything. Boating is everything, fishing's everything. Pine Island is such a unique, beautiful place. We like to come out here and just walk around. It's so interesting. And it's a beautiful island, and they took the full brunt of it. So we're heading a little bit south now towards Boquilla. Boquilla is on one end. Just, and the smell, I mean, you can even smell it from up here. Yeah. So some neighborhoods, the good news is some neighborhoods, you know, as we head south on Pine Island Road, look like some of the newer homes survived. We're headed now towards, on your left is Papaya Street, Tropical Point Drive, Citrus Street, Sable Palm, Tangerine, some of the neighborhoods here. And, geez, yeah. Roofs are gone. But many of the newer homes survived. The only problem with staying out here is that they're cut off from the mainland and there's no power, there's no water. We're headed down Stringfellow Road right now, headed south. Manufactured homes, RV resorts, yeah, an RV park. A lot of RV parks out on Pine Island. People come down here for a couple months or year-round, and this is the Pink Ibis and Eagle Lake Drive, again, heading down Stringfellow Road. Just blown off their foundations, tipped over, roof's gone. Belongings strewn everywhere. So all the little communities off Stringfellow Road, the main north-south. So now we're getting into, straight ahead, we're getting into Buttonwood Key, all of these people, waterfront homes, waterfront manufactured homes, a lot of small, the newer homes that have just been, look like they survived, but man, look at the little manufactured homes blown off their foundations, belongings everywhere, boats in yards, roofs torn off. This is a Treasure Cove right now that you're seeing. We're headed down like York Road and Sanibel Boulevard, and this is all known as Treasure Cove. And it's bad. Sebastian, you just have to hope all these people evacuated, because you can't imagine the water had to have been, you can't tell now, but the water had to have been inside. Yeah, this is Buttonwood Key we're looking at now, going into, and parts of Treasure Cove. Just see the damage. Coquilla, St. James City, I should say. It's gonna take a long time to recover from this. They are building the bridge right now, a temporary structure. The governor was in town yesterday announcing that it should be up by Saturday. So at least the people who evacuated can get back and try to salvage some of their belongings and start the rebuilding. And the people who stayed on the island who've been cut off, I'm imagining that most of them have been evacuated. They've evacuated close to 1,700 people from the barrier islands. So I'm hoping that they're not here anymore because they're cut off from everything, but at least they can come back. So we're looking now we're headed towards Buttonwood Key. They've asked everyone to leave Pine Island right now, just so they can go door to door and assess the situation. And they just want people to not be in danger. There's live wires here. There's, you know, they've cut off power, but there's just dangerous situations. There's, you don't know what you're gonna come across. Yep. It's just too dangerous. So these are all the canals in Buttonwood Key. You can see a lot of damage to these homes. Matlacha? Matlacha would be great, yeah. Oh, can we go a little to the back? Okay. I wanted to see Matlacha, but that's farther north, so that's okay. It's probably 2 miles north, 3 miles. Right where we came across from Captiva, it's right there. It's the island. Okay, go north. Up Stringfellow Road, the main road through the island. And it's basically the road that takes you back to Cape Coral. Yes. Perfect. are heading north now from St. James City, headed towards Matlacha. They are busy working on a bridge, so maybe we can check out the progress being made to make sure that they say by this weekend or early next week they will have a way to get on and off. Yeah, they definitely look like some kind of official boat. Headed to Matlacha Pass, Matlacha Isles. Let's see what looks like law enforcement or Coast Guard headed up to Matlacha as well. Sheriff's Office, Lee County Sheriff's Office. If you could just do a before and after picture, and you can imagine how green and lush the mangroves and the trees were and how blue the water was, and now everything is just brown. It's incredible. For miles. Seen some barges coming up through here, so hopefully they're going to be able to make progress quickly. I'm sorry, what'd you say? Progress? We did. She does. All right, we're heading up. This is Matlacha Pass. And how did a boat get here? Just unbelievable. Okay. Yep. This is Matlacha. We're coming up on the tiny island community in between the mainland and Pine Island. The road is washed out at this time. There have been reports of several bodies spotted in the canals the day after the storm. A lot of destruction. Bird's Bar is no more. Place where you like to stop and look at the water and enjoy everything Matlacha had to offer. The little art galleries, colorful. There's a little coffee shop here. Perfect Cup. Leoma Lovegrove had her gallery here. So this is Matlacha. You can see the damage to the bridge there. There are the tiny little galleries. And there's the bridge and where it was reached. A temporary structure is going up. So they're both, two different bridges have been breached on Matlacha, you can tell from here. Cars all along, just people from Pine Island who drove down to this area to try to get a ride back or a boat back. Look at all the cars. They rode out the storm here and they got trapped on the other side. And there's no water or food or stores. So they're walking down to the bridge in hopes of catching a ride. They're ferrying people back to the mainland. But this is Matlacha. Little homes. The homes are just crumpled into the water now. The bridge buckled with the force of the waves. The whole essence of this island is the water. I mean, look how close you are. You're living on the water practically, and that's what made it special, what made it so dangerous. Some structures survived, but not many. A lot of manufactured homes here, a lot of one-level cottages that, even if you can't see the water damage, all took on a tremendous amount of water. And then a lot of them are moved off their foundation. So these will all have to be, look at the amount of debris and destruction. You see emergency personnel, they're going door to door, they're marking what houses they've been to, they're doing wellness checks, just to make sure. Again, they already have, look at that, they already have the pavement trucks out here, the dump trucks, and they're rebuilding the bridge. Okay, that is us right there. Okay, so you see that peach-colored house? There were three houses next door to that peach-colored house, and they're not there anymore. Look at the destruction. Oh. Just the amount of debris that's going to be in our waterways is unbelievable. Homes are destroyed, but look at the progress they're making on the bridge in Matlacha to go to Pine Island. Yes, this is a temporary bridge, but they wanted to get it up quickly. Again, we had reporters out here the day after the storm, and we're hearing stories from people about... All right, I'm gonna head... Okay. Okay. Yeah, they're stopping people right on Pine Island Road in Cape Coral from going out to the island. You can see. Veterans Parkway.